Hello everyone, today we will discuss on power system stability. Now a power system stability is nothing but the ability of the system to remain under the stable condition. Power system operates in synchronous mode under the stable conditions. Power system is subjected to a wide range of disturbance in the real-time operation. It may be the small disturbance or it may be the large disturbance. Disturbance is due to load and generation changes, means if there is sudden change in the load, either sudden increase in load or sudden decrease in load due to the various load conditions, or if there is any changes in the generation due to some generation aspects, if there is any network changes, network fault or operational changes, whenever it requires, it will be system will treat this as a network sort of disturbance. Then faults and outages of equipments. So all these are categorized as a disturbance to the power system. It may be the small disturbance or it may be the large disturbance. Therefore, due to these disturbances, the stability of the power system will get affected. The power system stability involves the study of dynamics of power system under the disturbance conditions. From the classical point of view, power system instability can be seen as loss of synchronism, that is some synchronous machines going out of step when the system is subjected to a particular disturbance. Means whenever there is a disturbance to the power system in the real-time operation, if the disturbance is very large, it may impact that synchronous machine which is generating the power. They may lose the synchronism, and if they lose synchronism, we can say that the power system is going to lose its stable condition, or the power system stability is under the trouble. So according to the CIRGRE IEEE definition of power system stability, the power system stability is the ability of an electrical power system for a given initial operating condition to regain a state of operating equilibrium after being subjected to a physical disturbance, with most system variables bounded so that practically the entire system remains intact. Means whenever there is a runtime disturbance to the power system, if the disturbances are tolerable, so after that disturbance, it may regain the equilibrium condition. That is, power system may regain its equilibrium condition because of whatever physical disturbances are caused, or whatever physical disturbances are there in the system. And most of the disturbances are are bounded type of disturbances, by which once there is a disturbance, after that disturbance, within minimum time period, system will come under the stable condition. That is, practically the entire system remains intact to the synchronism. So stability involves study of dynamics of the system about an equilibrium initial operating conditions. Let's move ahead. The power system is highly non-linear system. Therefore, it is very important to study the stability of the power system. The study of non-linear dynamics of the large system involves the study of initial operating conditions as well as nature and magnitude of disturbance. Because unless and until we are not coming across the exact situation of the power system, that is under the disturbance, we cannot able to find out the solution for the power system stability. Therefore, it needs us to analyze the nature and the magnitude of disturbance. So definition applies to an interconnected power system as a whole. Most of the time, we're interested in the stability of the particular generator or group of the generator. So in the power system, or if you take an example of generating station or powerhouse, in that many generators are generating the electricity. So either one of the generator from that generating unit or generating power generating station is going to lose the synchronism, or a group of generators, they might lose the synchronism because of disturbances which are occurring in the power system. The system stability is divided into two parts. That is, first is steady state stability, and other is the transient state stability. In the steady state stability, the power system is undergoing through the disturbances which are gradual or which are gradually disturbing the system. For example, gradual load increases as in addition of MW at low terminals, or in gradual load decreases as in system changes at the prime mode power. So therefore, if the disturbances are gradual, means if the magnitude is not large, then that sort of disturbance to the system is steady state disturbance. And if system remains intact or stable in these conditions, we can say that steady state stability of the system is good. The power system in general and alternator in particular have steady state stability limit, beyond which, if subjected to gradual load changes, will lose the steady state stability. So every generator which is connected in the system is having its own steady state stability. So if the disturbance is beyond its the limit, it may lose the steady state stability. The power system is capable to resist the changes that occurs, the disturbance, and hence remain in stable form, that is capable of maintain equilibrium. So always after the disturbance, system tries to regain its original condition, by which the system can deliver the power under the stable condition to the load. The example of sudden changes, that is transient stability, are fault occurrence, auto closure schemes, energization process of TL, and de-energization of TL. So before this point, we have studied about the steady state stability. Now about the transient stability, if the disturbance in the system is very large and the duration of the disturbance is very less, then that sort of disturbance is called as transient disturbance. And as I said, if the system remains under the stable condition, even in the transient disturbance, then that sort of stability is called as transient stability. The disturbance, that is transient disturbance, may be because of faults. There are many types of faults which are occurring in the power system. It may be the symmetrical fault, it may be the unsymmetrical faults. Then due to the operation of some of the equipments in the system, that is auto reclosure schemes, or even under the operation of the circuit breakers, it will create the transient and it will disturb the system. So if the system is remaining under the stable condition, even under the these transient disturbances, then the stability of the system is recorded as a good one. Let's see some definitions. Steady state stability is the ability of the power system network to remain to stay in the equilibrium following a gradual system changes. The steady state stability limit is the maximum power transfer of that system without loss of synchronism. About the steady state and about the transient, when we have less magnitude, disturbance of less magnitude, and if it is for the longer duration, it is a sort of steady state disturbance to the power system. If the disturbance magnitude is very high, and if the disturbance duration is very less, then that sort of disturbance is a transient disturbance to the power system. Let's move towards some other points. According to American regulatory standards, the reliable operation means operating the elements of the bulk power system within equipment and electrical systems, thermal, voltage, and stability limits, so that Instability, uncontrolled separation, or cascading failures of such system will not occur as a result of sudden disturbance, including a cybersecurity incident or unanticipated failures of the system elements. So this is very broad definition of sort of which is related with the stability and the reliability of the power system. So under this three constraints has been considered. Out of this, the electrical constraint is there, then thermal constraint is there, and other is the sort of operational constraint is there. So due to the unstable operation of electrical power or electricity, there might be the instability in the load. There might be the uncontrolled separation or operation of the load which is connected to the electrical system, or there might be the cascading of failures of such system will not occur as a result of sudden disturbance. That means if there is an unstable operation of the system parameters or especially electrical power system, then there might be the impact onto the load, that is in terms of its uncontrolled operation, might be there will be a cascading failures of dependent systems and might be result in the sudden shutdown or sudden disturbance to the very large system. With this means disturbances of the category which has been considered in this broad definition is cybersecurity incident as well and anticipated failures of system elements. So due to any of these reasons or causes, that is sudden disturbance, cybersecurity incident, or unanticipated failures of the system elements, there might be its impact onto the load which is connected to the system. So therefore, it is prime responsibility of the utility system to deliver the power to the electrical load or to the consumers within the stable operations by which they can have the reliable operations. The American standard is for dynamic performance requirement. It is related to the security and the stability of the system parameters or power system. Then system operating limits, that is SOL, megawatt, MVAR, amperes, frequency, or volts that satisfy the most limiting of the operating criteria for a specified system configuration to ensure operation with acceptable reliability criteria. This is one of the security measures. So power system or utility system has to supply these parameters, that is frequency, voltage, within the standard tolerable limits, as well as per the demand of the consumer. It needs to provide MW, MVAR, as well the amperes. Let's move ahead. Interconnection reliability operating limits. This is concerned with the stability measure. So it is a SOL that if violates could lead to instability, uncontrolled separation, or cascading outages that adversely impact the reliability of the bulk power system. Now about SOL and IROL, following a contingency or other system event that causes the system to operate outside set reliability boundaries, transmission operators, that is TO, are obligated to return its transmission system to within SOL or IROL as soon as possible. So the contingencies, it means that unavoidable conditions or unexpected conditions in the system. So if you do have such kind of contingencies that earlier we have seen, it might impact onto the operating limits and reliability operation of the system. Therefore, the operators, that is transmission operators, have to take care about these two limits to have power system security and reliable operation of the power system. Let's say what is, let's study what is stability. As earlier we have discussed, it is the ability of the system to achieve the steady state operating condition even after the disturbing conditions. Now let's say this is the initial working condition of the system. Now after the disturbance, the system may get oscillate, and once that disturbance is going to nullify, the system once again is coming under the stable conditions. Means this shows the disturbance. This is for the frequency, and on x-axis we have time, on y-axis we have the frequency. So it shows that the system, if oscillations are more and more, so system will get disturbed in terms of this is with regards to the stability of the system. So this is very much concerned to the system as well as the load, by which we can have a sort of disturbance to the whole power system. Let's see about the stability during fault and right after the fault. The power system stability is determined by the capabilities of its generators to maintain connected to the grid, provide the extra reactive power, provide fast ramping down of real power. So after the fault or during the fault, the system needs to work out with all three conditions. That is, it needs to maintain or remain in synchronism with the grid, by which the continuity of the supply can be maintained and system can have its stability. Let us proceed with the further part of stability studies. Let's see first what is the security of the system. If the system is stable after a disturbance, the system is secure if all key components like voltage, terminal voltage, and the frequency as well, these are, if operating under the stable limits or operating under the limits, then we can say that the system is stable and we can claim that the power system is secure. If not, it will be not secure or not stable. Let us see what is a balance of power in the generators. So if mechanical power, let's see, this is the input mechanical power, that is PM, which is given to the generator, and this is power developed in the generator in terms of electrical power. So this power, mechanical power, is been controlled at the power plant, whereas the electrical power generated is controlled by the customers or consumers or by the load. So under the equilibrium condition or under the stable condition of the system, that is steady state condition, mechanical power is equals to the electrical power. That is, power input is equals to the power output. That is balance of power in the generator. Let's move ahead. The turbine speed and imbalance of powers. Now, as far as turbine speed and imbalance of power is concerned, once again, if there is a large, or if there is a change in the rate of change of speed of the turbine or alternator, the power output may going to change, and that will be going to imbalance the power of turbine and the alternator, or it will be going to imbalance the power of the system. Let's see. Once again, PM is the mechanical input power given to the turbine as well as generator, and PE is the electrical power output. As turbine and shaft of the alternator or synchronous machine, they are mechanically coupled. Whatever power is been fed to the turbine, same will be fed to the shaft of the alternator. That is, if PM minus PE is nothing but the rate of change in the if there is a change in the power, you can say that there is a change in the speed, where at a stable condition or normal steady state condition, n is equals to ns, that is the rotor speed is equals to the synchronous speed. At that point of time, we have electrical power is equals to the mechanical power input, that is power input is equals to power output. So rate of change of speed at that point of time or at steady state condition is equals to zero.